So you ready for baseball?
Baseball playoffs, man.
Playoffs.
Who said that back in the day? Is that some coach?
Jim Mora. He was a football coach for the Saints. Yeah.
Playoffs. That's one of my favorite playoff lines. Yes, I am ready for playoffs tonight. We've got North in town.
The North Huskies, yep, they won on Tuesday. Extra innings against Eau Claire Memorial.
Really?
A shootout, 17-12, I think was the score.
Oh, my goodness.
My understanding is North had a big lead, and I'm sorry, I think Memorial had a big lead.
Really?
North came back, and then obviously it was eight innings, and they put a pile on in that
the last inning.
In the eighth inning, wow. And able to hold on. But for Hudson tonight, they've got their ace out there with Burkhoff on the mound. The last time we saw Hudson play, not your typical Hudson performance with that game against Menominee.
No.
So, again, the warm-ups, everything looked pretty sharp tonight, and I think you got to feel pretty good about Burkhoff being on the mound. I mean, he's been the steady guy all year, and he faced these guys. I think when we covered the game against North before, it was 15-0.
He
just mows them down. He tendency to just pound that strike zone. So watch for that tonight. We'll get into kind of where things go from here. That one's a little high. Maddox Gertz is the leadoff batter. Gertz playing right field. Ball one. Burkhoff, not a lot of time, just getting into that rhythm.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I feel like last time that we played him, our last game that we had here, we had a bit of a lineup mix-up. Like, we were...
Yep, some things were... there's a strike. Things were mixed up a little bit, but you could just kind of see the energy and just the amount of errors and the mental mistakes were killing Hudson. Got him again inside corner.
Nice
just
pitch.
Throwing heat right now. 2-2. So, again, it's that steady presence of your ace on the mound. 2-2 pitch. That one's inside. Because this is the sectional final. Hudson got a bye.
Yeah.
And we'll talk a little bit about the other teams still in the mix and playing. But this is to go to Marshfield for sectionals, which would
That's a multi-game adventure, right?
Correct. Yep. Yeah. Yep. Got him there.
Bingo! Mark your bingo cards. Strike one. Excuse me. K1.
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 We should have the old K sign. We can hang them up.
Drop
here
those
from the
down.
Booth.
Yeah. I do like when they do that at baseball games. That's fun.
Logan Hesselman.
So answer me this. Mm-hmm. What's the difference between a K and a backwards K?
Looking. So that would have been if you're swinging,
that's a
straight up K. If you're looking, curveball inside that time.
Okay.
Yep. So that's.
Okay. I did not know that.
That's
Thank
the
you.
Difference.
Fun fact.
Yep. When you watch that third strike go by, you get the backwards. That one's in the dirt. 2-0.
Boy, he has quite the pace to his...
Yeah, just trying to dictate the tempo and high on that one. 3-0. And at the same time, you'll kind of notice he'll settle down a little bit, trying to start the game off with getting some rhythm and getting a feel for the strike zone. Gets that one. 3-1.
Umpire very deliberate in his strike call. I like that. Kind of a slow-mo walk back.
Foul back.
Foul ball.
Full count again. Yeah, those pitchers are, they understand that they're kind of in control. And
sure.
As best they can, they try to intimidate up at the mound there. That one's off the face mask there.
Ouch.
A little timeout. Teeth rattler.
That go off the ump's face?
Yeah, it did.
Oh, man.
90-mile-an-hour pitch with
gosh.
Fouled off. Full count. Fouled back again. That's going for some cars, Ken. Ooh, hit the parking lot.
Ooh.
Took a little side bounce. I parked back here in the back parking lot. I got here
back
early
40.
Enough, so it's going to take a poke to get to where I'm parked. Still full count. That one's fouled left side, out of play.
Ranth, I'm taking a run, but that one hits the fence here. I'm going to catch that one unless you're rolling the flash.
Speaking of which, that's coming out soon.
Yeah.
Plug a movie. I have no idea why I'd plug it. I get nothing. Looks kind of fun, though. My wife's ready to go to the Fast and the Furious, that last
oh,
one.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. We're kind
of I want to see the Mission Impossible. Of course, now it's right. That's two of them, so.
Oh, is that a?
It's a twofer.
Walked in there.
Good at that time by Hesselman. Draws the walk.
Yeah, fought off some of those strikes and hung around. Caught the walk at the end. Yeah, those double, what are those, is it like it's a sequel or
yeah,
whatever it's called. It's a two-part movie,
two-part,
basically, right?
It's a two-part.
It's a twoper.
Yep.
That's what the Oopers call it, a twoper.
Twoper. Braden Thillman is the batter, another lefty here. See what Burkhoff wants to do with that runner at first. Got a decent lead right now. Rambo over there.
Good strike.
Strike one. Burkhoff gives the runner a look, comes to the plate with a curveball, grounded down, foul down the first baseline. Quickly 0-2 here. So this will be Hudson's only playoff game at home, I should say.
Yeah.
Which was nice to have the bye, you know, with the holiday weekend and coming off last week. Again, conference champs, so nothing really... ground ball, that's going to get through the hole out to left field. Ramthan throws it in. So runners at first and second here for the Huskies. Just one out.
Hot one down the third there and just got through the gap.
Brings up the catcher, number 30, Jack Gorman.
On Hudson, if I remember right, they were the number two seed with Stevens Point being the one.
Yep,
is that right?
Yep, correct. So Stevens Point also received a bye, and we'll talk about how that works at sectionals here in a moment. First pitch, curveball in the dirt. Good block that time by Carlson. So as the number one seed, when they go to the sectionals over in Marshfield, if they win, they would get the early game. So we talked about that, how those games get stacked.
Yeah.
10 noon and 2. So winners play at 2 o'clock. Good pitch
good
that
strike.
Time.
Nice job.
So that's the benefit of being the one seed is you get a little bit extra rest time if you do make the sectional.
So it's two games that if you win your first, you play that the 2 o'clock is the, where
strike
the winners
again.
Play. And then the winner of that 2 o'clock game goes on to state. Is that correct?
Correct.
Okay.
Yep. So that's your sectional winner.
Got it.
So River Falls still alive in the sectional, as is Chippewa.
Oh,
take a look at those matchups here. Curveball outside that time. So don't have the bracket in front of me. River Falls was like a 5 or a 6 seed.
Okay.
And Chippewa was a 3. So that would tell me that the winner of the Chippewa game today, there you go, strike
nice.
Number 3. They will play the winner of this game. So how that will work. They won't reshuffle seeds.
Oh, okay. Got it.
But we'll take a look at the bracket, get all those matchups.
Yeah.
I think Wisconsin Rapids, again, still alive. DC Everest. Two outs here. That one looked
foul?
Like it went off the end of the bat.
It did.
I'm going to get him a hit by pitch that time.
Oh. Pitcher number
22. Just how that came off, it certainly looked like it hit the butt end of the bat, which would have been a foul ball. We've seen that before, but no appeal by the Hudson bench. So bases are loaded here.
A little action going for North early on. Two outs, bases loaded.
Brings up the pitcher, Trenton Palmer. A lot of lefties, so they're throwing a lot of lefties. Lefty on lefty, that's a tougher, can be a tougher matchup for a left-handed pitcher going against a left-handed batter.
Yeah.
You know, you see that at all levels. That's when they'll typically bring in a pinch, a different pitcher a lot of times. So all of a sudden you see in the major leagues if a team starts to get into trouble and the next batter's coming up, they'll probably bring a lefty on a lefty. 2-0. That one's in there for a strike.
There you go.
I don't remember this many left-handed batters in that lineup. Maybe they're spread out a little bit more today.
Yeah, it seems like everybody so far has been a lefty, right?
That one's, oh, fair Ooh, ball. Boy. Gets just inside the line. It's going to die in the grass. Two runs are going to come in. On that single, just kind of stayed about a foot inside the line. You could see it from our vantage point pretty easily.
Yeah, great line drive down the line there. And like you said, just a foot inside the bag. And
opposite field, knocks in a couple runs. Eau Claire North takes a 2-0 lead. Runners advance to second and first and second. So Palmer, the pitcher, helps his cause there with a two RBI single. Brings up the third baseman, James Jerzynski. Big swing and a miss there. Picking up some good noise from the dugouts out there.
Yeah. Yep, good chatter out there by both dugouts, especially North right now. Kind of rallying here with two outs and just punch two in.
Curveball in there, ooh, just a little low.
Just a bit low.
Runner at second, not really being covered there. Zuli fakes and goes back. Just misses outside. Strike zone's a little tight today.
Very tight, yes.
Not sure. The count shows 2-1 on the scoreboard. Do you have 2-1 or 3-1?
I got 2-1.
Okay. 2-1. Foul back. Good cut on that. Evens the count at 2-2.
Two outs. Hudson needs to put a period on this one and move on.
Two and two on the number 7 batter, Jerzynski. Burkoff takes a look at second, comes to the plate. That one's outside. Count is full. Runners will be moving on the pitcher. See what Ben wants to come back with. Fastball. That one's lined out, kind of a blooper. Looks like it's going to drop over the second baseman's head. Runner comes in. Throw gets airmailed over the top. They're going to try to score another run here. Got the tag down in time.
Got him.
To retire the runner there.
But score for one, though, right?
Yep. North gets one on that bloop hit. For North, three runs on three hits. Two left. After one half inning, it's Eau Claire North 3, Hudson coming up.
Welcome back to Raider Field. Ken Conan, Aaron Sundin, Jeff Tierstig on the camera today. North getting off to a strong start. Three of them that first inning here. Hudson coming out at the bottom of one here, looking to get a little something going.
Yeah, and you know, again, go back to last week. No runs in that last game against Menominee. So Hudson's certainly looking to get going early here, not wanting to drag this out, get to a point where they want to give Burkoff some of these runs back for
yeah,
sure.
Yeah, give him some room to work.
Center fielder Peyton Lawrence leads off. That Whoa. One's high. So I don't think we saw Palmer.
I got real excited yeah. about that ball.
After a long game, an 8-inning game with 29 runs the other night against Memorial. I don't wow. know how deep this pitching staff is for North. So if I had to guess, they're kind of banking on Mr. Palmer to go deep in this game.
Carry the weight here, yeah.
1-1. Line drive, second baseman grabs it for the first out. Real quick, I'll give you your matchups that are going on tonight. So Stevens Point, at Stevens Point, plays Wausau West, the 8 seed. River Falls is at Wisconsin Rapids. Lincoln River Falls was the 5 seed. Lincoln is the 4. Chippewa plays at home against DC Everson, of course, tonight. Eau Claire North and Hudson here. Hunter Carlson, the batter. Curveball that time in there for a strike. That one's low. 1-1.
Palmer, is he a junior for North? Do you know?
He's a senior.
Senior, okay.
Curveball that time in there. Whoa. For a strike.
Good looking curveball.
Certainly not the speed that Burkhoff has, but
no.
You know, again, throw strikes, yep. Make your help your defense or get help from your defense to make plays. 1-2. Jams him that time up the first baseline, gobbled up by the first baseman. Makes the play unassisted for out number 2.
And now batting second baseman, number 7, Landon Zuli.
2 outs here. Second baseman Landon Zuli up to the plate. First pitch from Palmer to Zuli. That one's in the dirt. Ball 1.
It's not as humid as I was thinking it might be in the booth tonight. I was thinking it might be a little bit of a sauna.
Were you getting some thunder up here before the game?
Yeah, we were.
I don't know where that went, but curveball high that time.
So when I peeked at the old Doppler or the whatever app is on my phone, it looked like it was sliding kind of north and east. You know what I mean? It was coming up, but it was sliding off to the east.
Ground ball, that could get up the middle. Second baseman gets it on a high hop, sets and throws. Oh, he's safe.
Hey now.
He's safe.
Here we go.
Zuli kind of gave the safe sign coming across the base there, and he was right. Nice play by the second baseman, though, to get that. Had to throw off 1 foot, but Zuli legged it out for the infield single.
All right, we'll take that. Get something going here. Especially with Bussin coming up.
Yeah, senior shortstop Jake Bussin at the plate. Huge year for him in the Big Rivers Conference. I know they had their all-conference selections last night.
Oh, really?
I did not hear about that. It may not have been announced yet, but I'm sure there are several Raiders that are on that list.
Sure.
Curveball that time. A little low. Oh, they're going to give him a strike on that.
Strike came through on the swing. 1-1.
Zuli with a decent lead over there. Ooh, boy. That was tight, but
boy, that
called
seemed,
it a strike.
Yeah. Seemed tight, but.
One and two here on Bussin. High that time. 2-2.
Boy, those hot dogs. It's just blowing right in here, isn't it? It's like they're making them right at my feet. Oh, gosh.
Got him. Got him looking.
Wow.
Painted that inside corner and a couple pitches there. Those are jam jobs for those right-handed hitters. Sure. 4 Hudson, no runs, 1 hit, 1 left. After 1 inning, it is Eau Claire North 3, Hudson 0.
Again, welcome back to Raider Field here. North up by a couple of them right now. Hudson with a pretty quick inning there. Thought we might have something cooking.
Weathers gets a hold of that one, but fouled on the right side. So they're kind of timing up Ben here. See what he does as far as timing on the mound, if he continues to try to dictate the pace and move at a little quicker pace. Weathers, the number 8 batter. Fastball that time, got the corner, 0-2.
There you go.
Yep.
Heard that out of the dugout. I like the old yep.
That one's in the dirt. 1-2.
That always reminds me of that Storage Wars show. Have you ever watched? You
yes,
ever got sucked into
yes,
that guy?
Knucklehead. Oh, I can't remember his name, but yep.
I always kind of wanted to go to one of those just to see the.
Got him swinging.
There you go.
Yeah, that guy. Nobody liked him.
No,
because he was. He'd kind of wait till the end, and then all of a sudden he'd be like, yep.
Have you ever
so
been
no
to
interest
like
in it?
An auction like
no,
that before?
No.
The only auction I've ever been to was a hockey store up in Anoka.
Yep.
That went out of business. And somehow, when we were, you know, young coaching parents, we heard about it. Everything.
Oh,
sticks.
I've been to auctions before, like, not to one of those storage ones, though. You know, where you don't know what's
there?
In there. Yep.
Okay.
Ryan Hull, the batter. Hull, the number 9 batter in center field.
Yeah, the not knowing what's in it in the storage locker is like a whole other.
Right.
Whole other deal, right?
Got him on
Got
that
him
one.
Again. Wow. All right, Berkoff, here we go. Dial it up.
Well, and you got to know kind of the little intricacies of what's valuable, what's not.
Sure.
I mean, everybody knows a TV or knows, you know, furniture, that kind of stuff. Got him. Carlson sets and throws down to first base for out number 2. Nice job that time. Just setting his feet, making sure he made a solid throw, got up the line to make that on a straight line.
At Carlson, right?
Yep. No. 4 strikeouts so far for Berkoff. 2 outs here brings up the leadoff batter, Maddox Gertz.
Woo! He's back. Some heat right there. I love it when it hits the glove and the dust goes flying. Woo.
That one off.
Off the face.
Carlson's face mask, I think. Quick 0-2 count here. Again, 2 outs.
I like how the ump gives him a second to regroup. He was going to clean the plate if he needed to, but he's like, no, we're good.
That's the courtesy of baseball.
Yeah. 0-2.
That one's in the dirt.
I like that. Nice job, ump. I don't know if we've seen this guy before.
No, I don't think we've had this crew yet.
See a new crew.
1-2 here. Berkoff delivers. Got him swinging. 3 strikeouts
bingo!
In that inning for Berkoff.
Mark your bingo card. K-time.
5 on the day so far. 4 north. No runs, no hits. Nobody left. After 1.5, it is North 3, Hudson 0.
Welcome back to Raider Field. It's Ken Conan, Aaron Sundin, Jeff Terstig on the camera tonight. Sun is starting to peek out here. And
bottom of 2. Number 16, Braden
Bazanson. Baba Bowie. Baba Bowie.
There it is.
Baba Bowie.
Baba Bowie Bazanson.
Baba Bazanson. Here we go.
Bazanson had a big night the last time these teams played at home here. That one's in the dirt. I think he was 4 for 4. Bunch of RBIs, so see if he can get things going here. Bottom of the 2nd, Hudson down 3-0. North with just 2 hits, Hudson with 1. That one's hit, solid out to center field, but right at the center fielder for out number 1.
He didn't move but a step back, I think, when he caught it. Making it too easy with some of these hits. We got to hit to where they're. What was the old saying?
Hit it where they ain't.
Hit it where they ain't. That's right.
Gavin. Wyatt Gavin. Let's go. Right fielder up to the plate. Curveball high that time. Yeah, make the pitcher work a little bit. He's only got 19 pitches so far.
Right.
Put a little pressure on him. Of course, again, he's getting some favorable calls on that curveball inside for sure. That one's high. 2-0. See if Gavin can get something going here. 2-0 pitch. Likes that inside corner.
Mm-hmm.
2-1.
Mm-hmm. 2-1, 1 out. Bottom of 2.
Fouled off that time. 2-2. You need to have Here Comes the Sun.
I do. I probably need to, like, call you sometime.
We'll get our tunes.
We can get our tunes all squared away, yep.
That one's high, good hold by Gavin. Full count.
Get a ball there.
Yes.
Thank you. He's throwing some more water in the old mug here.
Got him.
Huh. I was thinking that one might be high, but called strike.
Yeah, that one looked like it was about chest high. A couple pitches before that were definitely a little higher than that. So,
okay.
All right, two outs here. Eli Rambo up to the plate. That one's inside. Little paper towel protector there.
Yeah, just to
keep the heat off.
Shed the heat off there a little bit.
That one's in there. Nope, low. Right down the pipe. Must have just been a little low that time. 2-0. Palmer 2-0 here. Comes in that time with a strike. Well, this has kind of been a little bit of the bugaboo for Hudson this year is run scoring, you know, the offensive side. That one's hit well to the
gap.
That's
a good spot.
It's going to get over
hey
the
now,
left fielder's
let's
head
go.
All the way to the fence. Kind of took a line on it. Rambo's going to come in standing
here
up at
go.
Second. Good hit that time. Looked
and
like
his
the
name is John Cena.
Substitute Rambo instead of John Cena there, and you know what we're doing up here. We're having fun. Big double.
Eli Ramthen up to the plate here. That one was well hit, obviously, but it looked like the left fielder might have had a bead on it. Took a more of a direct angle instead of a dropping back, and it just went over his head all the way to the fence. That one's in there for a strike.
Boy, that Rambo, he can get hit.
That one's in the dirt. Rambo's going to take off.
Oh, boy.
Oh, he's there.
Yeah. The big rig hustling on over.
That was a nice read by him. That was not a called steal. He saw it was in the dirt, had a pretty good secondary lead, and just kind of took off. Face first, head first into third.
Rolling.
The significance of that is a wild pitch scores a run here. So that one's outside. 2-1 here on Ramthen.
Yeah, that's a good call. Pitch gets away from you. You get to Rambo charging at you.
Getting a pretty good lead there. That was 3-1, so that was a five-pitch walk for Ramthen.
I was going to say, that was just the third ball, wasn't it? One strike, right? 3-1.
That one's in the dirt. Gets away from the catcher, but Rambo decides probably smart there not to take off.
Ramtham knew that walk was coming. He just like wanted to let us know before it happened. It was kind of like a prequel.
Now batting for Hudson, third baseman, number 5, Sam Abrahamson.
All right, brings up the number 9 batter, Sam Abrahamson. Runners at the corner for Hudson. Coach Blagan get a little fired up down there in the box at third.
Okay, money time.
Throw over to first. Runner back. Ramthen with a decent lead there. I don't know if Hudson will take a chance trying to get him down to second. That one's high.
Curveball working, just a bit high.
One and zero here on Abrahamson. That one's inside. He's going to call that all day.
He does like
that
pitch.
Talk about that in the dugout. He's coming at you with that, coming slow and what happens there, you want to open up that front foot a little bit, turn on that, because that's a meatball that can be hit, that can be pulled if you're a right-handed batter. That one's popped up. Second baseman chases it. Right fielder calls for it and makes the catch to retire the Hudson threat. For Hudson, no runs on a hit. Two left. After two innings, it is Eau Claire North 3, Hudson 0.
Well, quick shout-out to the Rhinos Foundation. July 14th, they have a huge annual golf tournament. This is the 26th year that the Rhinos will be having their golf tournament. If you're not familiar with the Rhinos, they support families that are dealing with cancer in western Wisconsin and help them out in the order of giving them checks or whether it's...
I don't think I'm on, am I?
Oh, you're on.
Okay.
Yeah, I wouldn't leave you
all
off,
right,
buddy.
All right.
So great, great organization. The really cool thing. I'm on the board, by the way. Quick disclosure. We're all volunteers. There's nobody's taking a paycheck. Nobody's taking a cut. It's all the money that comes in goes out.
Yep. Absolutely.
Which
great,
is super
great organization.
Cool.
Yeah. Hessel in the batter. Walked and scored back in that three-run first inning for North. Burkhoff delivers. That one's in there. Nothing but strikes for him now. He's kind of hitting a groove.
Getting into the funk here.
0-2. Curveball that time's outside.
I'm going to finish my plug for the Rhinos if I can.
Yeah.
So if you go to rhinosfoundation.org and you'd like to play in the golf tournament, foursome is $500, and that gets you lunch, golf, strikeout, key time, and just an all-around great time. We'll be out at Clifton Hollow. It's July 14th, so it's the Friday of River Falls Days and has been since the beginning. So, again, if you get a chance, sign up. They are going quick. Yeah, great organization, great time out there, too.
Yeah.
Thank you.
I think, you know what, just thinking about that, that might be the same weekend as Fun Fest in Richmond, too.
Fun Fest.
So they kind of compete against each other, Fun Fest and River Falls Days. Strike one here.
Wow. He is bringing the heat right now. And
I'm
Fun
sorry,
Fest,
Thelman.
Do you guys do something for Fun Fest over there?
Well, yeah, so okay. I'm on the chamber board over there, so
yeah.
I help with that. 0-2 pitch, ground ball off the plate. See if that one's going to roll foul. Grab it. There you go. Fouled off. So yeah, and it's a big festival too. I think both they're community festivals, right?
Yeah,
so it's
yeah.
New Richmond people typically, yeah. River Falls people for River Falls Days, the Booster Days, of course, in Hudson. This is the 4th of July
Huge.
Weekend, and it ends up being mostly people from out of town.
Isn't that funny how that
so,
works?
But it's always been that way.
Yeah.
Not that people from town don't certainly go, but
yeah.
They get big crowds, and a lot of them are boat people. So this is that time, 1-2. So
that is a blast,
yeah,
too, by the way.
But you've got, I don't know if I ever probably didn't tell you this, but back when I was in my 20s, pre-kids, pre-marriage, everything else, me and a couple of buddies thought, let's see how many of these festivals we can hit. And so we kind of started, Good Neighbor Days in Roberts. That was that's coming up probably this weekend,
it
in
is.
Fact.
Yeah, yeah.
Aquafest, Muskie Fest.
Oh
so
my.
Aquafest is Rice Lake, Muskie Fest, Jack Pine Savage Days in Spooner, Farm and Feather Fest in Barron, Rutabaga Fest in Cumberland. I went to the Corn Fest somewhere. I think that was Almina or something like that. River Falls Days. That one's popped up. Jammed them. Rambo calls for it and makes the catch. So it was quite an achievement, Ken. We represented well.
Legendary. Legendary. And that's all in one summer.
That was one summer. Yep, it was just kind of.
Loving it. What a fun summer for you guys. That's awesome.
It was, instead of wedding crashers, we were festival crashers.
Yeah, that's perfect.
So,
well, I bet you guys brought a lot of fun to those festivals.
It was a good time. Gorman, the batter, swings and misses behind that pitch. 0-1. But there are some fun ones. I highly recommend one late in the year is up in Cumberland called Rutabaga Fest. They do a knockdown, drag-out job, swing and a miss again.
What time of year is that? I feel
that
like I've
is,
driven up to
like
the cabin.
That's like the third weekend in August, so it's before Labor Day.
Yep, yep.
And what they do, what they've done for years is they've really gone out and spent money on good bands.
Mm-hmm.
So they've had, got him, three straight
Woo!
K-time! Strikes, three straight swings, three straight swings and misses. For North, no runs, no hits, couple strikeouts for Burkhoff. After 2.5, Eau Claire North 3, Hudson 0.
Welcome back to Raider Field. Bottom of three. Couple early ones by North, and kind of quiet on the Western front by both squads since.
Yeah, well, Burkhoff settled down, and I think he's up to 7 strikeouts now.
Yeah, he's rolling.
But this offense needs to get going. I mean, he's not going to give up a lot of runs. That was kind of an anomaly, and I think he's going to stay in control here. But Hudson needs to put some pressure on Palmer. First pitch to Lawrence is a ball. So we're back to the top of the order here.
Who do we got here, Bet?
Peyton Lawrence.
Thank you.
That one's low. 2-0.
The sun has come out in full force all of a sudden here, too.
That one's in there for a strike.
Likes those chest level strikes.
2-1 here on Lawrence. Got him again on that inside corner. That's a spot he likes there that as far as the umpire goes. And, again, you're not going to change it. All you can do is be prepared for it.
Yep.
2-2. That one's inside. That one's too tight.
Full count.
Popped up. Back towards the backstop goes the catcher. Sets up and makes the catch. Gorman for the first out.
Now batting for Hudson. Catcher number 10, Hunter Carlson.
Brings up Hunter Carlson. Carlson grounded out to first is back in the first inning for Hudson. Check swing that time down the first base line. Same thing. First baseman takes it himself and retires Carlson. Just kind of a check swing that time. I don't know if he really wanted that pitch, but.
Stepping up to the plate now for the Raiders. Second baseman, number 7, Landon Zuli.
Brings up second baseman Landon Zuli. Hudson again just kind of coming in here with a purr.
Feels like Palmer's pitch count is.
He's at 42.
Okay.
Line drive base
there
at
you
that
go.
Time. That's kind of what I've been seeing up here. Those pitches that are coming straight across the plate aren't coming hard.
Yeah.
You just got to mentally prepare yourself that this is where you want it. Be prepared to adjust, especially on that curveball. It's not coming in very fast. And when it's coming in tight like it has been and the calls have been going against the Raiders there, that's where you got to really pick it up quickly and turn on it. Curveball that time in their first strike.
Yeah, that's definitely his bread and butter there, that outside edge curveball, and then he'll bring that one inside too, right?
Yep. That one's outside.
Just a bit outside.
And actually, I mean, his fastball and his curveball, there's a little bit of a different speed to it, but it's not dramatic, you know? Jammed off the end of the bat. Second baseman fields it and throws over to one to retire Hudson here in the third. For the Raiders, no runs, one hit, one left. After three innings, we're still sitting at 3-0, Eau Claire North.
Well, welcome back to Raider Field. We've got a packed house over on the grassy knoll.
Man,
off to our
sure
left.
Do. I didn't notice that before, but there's a lot of people 100 here.
100-plus folks over there kind of piled in under the a handful of trees that are kicking off a little bit of shade, but great crowd over here. Fun to see.
Need them to start making a little noise when we're up to the plate,
yeah.
Huh?
Get them going a little
Wake
bit, right?
Up.
Yeah. Need a little Happy Gilmore running down there. Let's go!
Yeah.
Get going!
First baseman Chase Watkins here to lead off the fourth. In there for a strike. Like I said, Burkhoff the last couple innings just humming right along. Three up, three down, both innings.
Seems to have got his mojo going.
That one's lined out to center field. Lawrence got some wheels, able to make the catch. Oh, nice catch. Job. Had to get on his horse there. Started to slow down as he saw the ball coming up, back pedaled, made the catch.
Yeah, great grab out there at center. So we'll see the pitcher up here.
Trenton Palmer up to the plate. Knocked in a couple runs in that first inning. First pitch from Burkhoff in their first strike. Just missed on that one.
Mm-hmm. Juicy.
One and juicy.
One and one.
That one's lined oppo again. He got that, did that as first at bat, too, but pitchers. That one went down the third base line. So two for two so far for Mr. Palmer.
Good little hitter, that Palmer.
Going to have a courtesy runner for him, number 12, Aiden Pankratz.
Now batting third baseman, number 5, James Jarzynski.
Brings up Jarzynski, who singled and knocked in a run back in the first. Would not expect them to try to sacrifice here. They're getting production up and down the lineup. Guys at least hitting the ball.
Yeah.
Are making contact with the exception of the 7 strikeouts for Mr. Burkhoff. 1-0 here in Jarzynski. That one's check swing foul towards the Eau Claire North dugout.
Woo. That was hot.
I saw about a week and a half ago, maybe it was a week ago, the Brewers, one of their best players, their shortstop, got a foul ball into the dugout. Hard hit ball.
Mm-hmm.
Concussion protocol, all that. But it happens at all levels. You always got to be kind of keeping an eye. We got fences here, but you can see there's just enough of a gap to be able to get the ball through that. 2-1. That one's in there for a strike. 2-2.
Yeah, we caught a Saints game last week, Friday, and we're down the third baseline, 9 rows up. Great, really cool seats.
Yeah.
But, I told the crew, I sat to the right of everybody to try to, if they weren't paying attention.
Yep. Got him.
There you go. Nothing came close, but I'll tell you, they come fast when they come down that line sometimes.
And a lot of times, say it's a right-handed batter and you're down the third base line in the stands, you think, well, those are pulled fouls. You're kind of watching that way, but it's those opposite field ones. Mm-hmm. It's the ones that come off kind of the weird angles off the end of the bat. Swing and a miss that time. Knox Weathers the batter.
You're exactly right. Those lefties that got up there, the third base line could be hot down there.
Absolutely. Yep. Going. Carlson sets and throws.
Got him.
Oh, nope. Dropped the ball.
Oh, goodness.
The throw was a little bit off the bag. Bussin went for the sweep tag, but the ball popped out. So stolen base that time for Pankratz. One and one here. Two outs. Pankratz, the runner at second. Swing and a miss again. 1-2.
Is he 90 on that?
Yeah, he's been clocked in the low 90s.
Wow.
Again, going to North Dakota State next year. Oh, boy, didn't miss by much there.
Mm-mm.
Yeah, he's legit. Big kid, throws hard, mixes it up, good temperament. So I wish him the best of luck. I think he's going to have a nice college career there. That one's high. Full count.
Said North Dakota?
North Dakota State.
Fun.
Yep, out in Fargo.
Looks like we got a football player that went
there. The Bison.
We were old, what's his name, 2 years ago?
You're thinking of Mateo Bonin.
Yeah, Bonin.
He's at South Dakota.
Oh, South Dakota.
Yep. That one's fouled off. So there's a Stoffel kid, Joe Stoffel from River Falls, plays at NDSU. He's the tight end there. And, Mateo and also Bounting, Troy Bounting, are at South Dakota.
South Dakota.
the Coyotes. Full count here. That one's fouled off, right side, out of play.
Full count, two outs.
Unofficially, I've got on the scoreboard 76 pitches so far for Burkov. So North doing a pretty good job getting him deep in the counts.
Mm-hmm.
That one's in the dirt. Good block by Carlson. Runner at second does not advance. So Weathers is on with a two-out walk. So now runners at second, first and second. Brings up Ryan Hull, the number nine batter. Struck out his first at bat in the second. We are in the fourth inning here. Eau Claire North leading 3-0.
All those runs, first inning, just boom, boom, boom.
Yeah, a couple of walks and just some timely hits. Squares to bunt. That one's fouled. Trying a little sneaky bunt there. He wasn't thinking sacrifice. He's trying to go down that first baseline, maybe leg out a infield single. Nonetheless, strike one. It's high. Throw down to second. Pankratz, the runner, getting a pretty good secondary lead there, so Carlson trying to keep him in line.
Keeping it real over there.
Bussin behind the runner there. That one's a strike.
Nice.
One and two.
Yeah, North getting them out on the bases here, giving themselves a chance. Oh, one and two, two outs.
Ooh, that one gets away. Curveball that time.
Both the runners.
He did not hit the batter, but he certainly shielded any opportunity for Carlson to try to knock that down. So that's a wild pitch from Burkov. Moves the runners to second and third.
Got two and two there?
Two and two.
Yes.
A lot of noise coming from that Husky dugout.
Mm-hmm.
2-2 pitch from Burkov. That one's a little high. Full count. Warning over to the bench there. I think they were banging on the fence.
Got it.
The natives are restless in the north dugout.
You can make noise, just don't bang on the fence.
3-2. Fouled off.
Fighting it out here.
So Burkov again at 83 pitches. Got him. Oh, boy. Wow. I had a pretty good beat on that one, Ken.
Yep. And what'd you think?
Well, that was a strike. But doesn't matter what I think.
Bases loaded.
Coach Blagan just...
Take a moment with his pet.
Going to take a little walk out to the mound. So Burkov, back in the first, had a couple walks, able to get out of it, humming along here for two innings or so, and then, again, this inning, single walk, just trying to calm him down. We're back at the top of the order here, up with Maddox Gertz. A couple strikeouts for him so far this game. See if Burkov can compose himself and get out of this inning.
Yeah.
What I was going to mention is, typically during a week, you've got games, say, Tuesday, Thursday. Once you hit your 100, you're not going to pitch the next game. This is a little different. So Burkov gets his 100, but if Hudson does advance, he's going to be able to pitch in that sectional game.
Okay,
so if they decide to start him game one or whatever they do. But
then you got to have another pitcher for the next game.
Correct.
Yep.
So that one's high. So we're gonna see another pitcher today. It's gonna be interesting to see which direction Hudson decides to go with. I would guess it's probably Bussin, but that one's in there for a strike. 1-1.
Yep. If I was a betting man, I'd guess the bus would be up next.
What that does, though, it does hurt your defense because now your best defender in the infield is out in there for a strike.
Sure.
1-2. So we'll see. Maybe keep an eye on that bullpen for Hudson. If we see somebody else warming up, maybe Coach Blagan's got a different idea. 1-2 here. Two outs. Bases are loaded. Burkhoff delivers. That one's lined to short. Bussin fields it. Easy toss over to second to get the force out.
Woo! Get me nervous.
Yep, North threatens. No runs on one hit, couple walks. They're able to get out of it, though. After 3.5, it is North 3, Hudson 0.
Buzz Hansen.
See if Braden can get something going here. First pitch, line out to right field. He's got to get on his horse. That one's going to get to the fence. Bounces off. Bazanson runs into second base.
Let's
standing.
Go.
Just smoked that one. First pitch, leadoff double for Bazanson.
Let's go. Come on.
A little noise coming out of that Hudson dugout. Wyatt Gavin, the batter. That one's outside. One and one, Gavin. Swing and a miss that time. Took a little off that one. 1-1. Too tight. 2-1. Two-one pitch here. That one's lined out
there
to center
go.
Field. Gonna drop. Oh, I thought he might not get
so
to that
too.
One. Looked like it didn't have a lot of loft on it, but again, that center fielder not having to move a whole lot. Couple well-hit balls here from Hudson here to start the fourth inning. Brings up Rambo, doubled his last at-bat, stranded, so let's see if he can trade places here with Bazanson. 54, the official count for Trenton Palmer on the pitch count.
54, so he's a good 20-something less than a...
Yeah.
Wow.
Yep. Big cut that time. Swing and a miss, 1-1.
Rambo was ready to tattoo that one out to left again.
That's in there for a strike. I had an obstructed view briefly from Old Glory, so... A little late on that count. 1-2. That one's high. Yeah, if you're Hudson, I mean, not a lot of opportunities with base runners today. Palmer doing a good job. Not sure if he's issued a walk yet. Maybe just one.
Yeah, I think so, just one.
And
it's on Rantham.
Ground ball. Oh, it's going to get through to the shortstop. He's going to throw off 1 foot. That's going to be off. It's going to score a run.
Oh, here
for
we
Hudson.
Go. Get on in.
Going to get in.
Bazanson.
Rambo legs it over to second base.
Let's go.
Actually, nice job in the hole by the shortstop to field that, but probably not the best decision to make that throw. You could see from the camera angle, a couple two hops there, got away from the first baseman. So I did say Rambo switched spots. He was probably thinking he'd like a double, but nonetheless, he's on.
Yeah.
I would score that as a base hit and an error on the overthrow.
Come on.
pinch runner steal homie in there for Hudson. Brings up Eli Rantham. Yep. Ramthan. I keep getting that wrong. Rantham. It's M and N.
Rantham.
Ramthan. All right, one out here. Raiders with one run in. Swing and a miss that time.
Eli looking for that one. Good cut.
The hot dog smoke's going right over the ump's shoulder.
Throw him off. Swing and a miss again. 0-2. Just misses outside that time. 1-2.
Trying to frame that one up.
Yeah, I see the smoke you're talking about there. 1-2. That one's fouled off the handle and out of play.
1-2. One out. 60 on the pitch count, I heard. Thank you.
Hard hit that time, Coach Blagan. Tried to give a little kick save, but thought better of it. That one rolls down to the bullpen.
Blagan looked like a goalie there for a hot second.
Yeah.
Pretty quick.
He moves a little more agile than Coach Revor. Coach Revor just jumps and gets about a 4-inch vertical. And
4 inches? Whoa.
maybe more if it's a hot shot. Who knows? Still 1-2. Oh, I smell the hot dogs now.
Right.
Ball outside.
Just a bit outside.
2-2, one out. Eli battling here in the box.
Ooh, got him.
Oh, he's wearing that one, but a walk will be issued.
That'll work. Get a little pressure on that pitcher.
Eli definitely a tough guy out there. He'll walk down to first and
Abrahamson
coming in.
Quick little mound visit by the Husky coach.
The walk up music for Sam.
Mm-hmm.
The hungrier I get, the more I smell those hot dogs.
Oh, Kenny.
Gosh, I can't get the smell out of my nose right now. It's driving me crazy. Go crazy.
You're just going to have to wait until the inning's over. We got a rally going.
Yeah, I'm not going anywhere.
All right. Coach Blagan down with a little pep talk to Abrahamson here. See if it pays off. Probably tell him, be picky. Get up there. Be aggressive, but be smart. First pitch to him. Fouled off the end of the bat. 0-1. Tell you what.
What do you got?
I'll get you a hot dog in between innings. How's that?
Oh, baby!
Who loves you? Who loves you,
you
baby?
You do. You do. I appreciate it. High and inside. Every time we get a hot dog here, I always think back to the hot dog we had here.
The Inferno dog.
A year or two ago when it was the hottest hot dog you've ever had.
Three innings later, it was still too hot to eat.
Oh, it was scorched dog. It was unbelievable. And then the bun.
The bun gave up and just said, I'm done.
I can't
suck
do it
all
anymore.
The moisture out of me.
Do it anymore. I'm a rock.
2-1 here on Sam. Misses that time.
Good eye, good eye. Here we go. 3-1, one out. See if he gets something here. All right, give him something.
Cool. Good cut that time. Like to see him being aggressive. That's good.
Yep.
Full count. Still only one out. Hudson with one run in. 3-2 pitch. That one's fall back.
Okay. Good battle. Good battle.
Yeah, the Hudson batters this inning getting a little deeper in the count. Count still full on Abrahamson. That one's high. Took a little bit off the curveball. Looked like it was across the plate, but just a little high. So runners do move up. Hudson's back to the top of the order here. Peyton Lawrence.
Ducks on the pond. All the bases getting a little coverage right now. Speaking of coverage, I wonder if Jeff's getting sunburned out there.
Oh, yeah, I bet he is now.
Poor guy.
Infield in for the Huskies. They're going to try to protect that two-run lead. Anything on the ground, going to try to come to the plate. See if Peyton can get one to the green out there in the outfield. One out. Fouled off. First baseman gives chase, but that's going to get out of play.
Lively fourth inning here for Hudson. Getting back to the top of the lineup, Lawrence at bat. 0-1, one out.
Swing, foul back. 0-2.
Well, pitcher ahead here on Lawrence, 0-2.
Good lead at third down there. Homie looking to maybe get that one's fouled back again. So Lawrence staying alive.
Mm-hmm. That might be another one we'd want to queue up. Staying alive.
Especially for baseball softball. You got to have
that. Yeah. When they're just battling.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
High that time.
Good eye.
So after three straight foul balls, Peyton gets a ball himself. 1-2. That one's inside. Going to get away from
gets
the
away.
Catcher. Run comes in.
Booyah!
Other runners advance. Homie comes in on the pass ball. It's the importance of that spot at third. You can score on those pass balls. Count goes to 2-2. Raiders with another run here. Still only one out.
Push the runners around to third and second. Score one.
There's a line
drop
drive,
it.
Base hit, that's going to drop.
Here we
that's
go.
Score one. They're going to send the runner from second.
Good throw, cut
off. He's in there.
Boom, boom.
Good hustle that time. Abrahamson came around. Play at the plate would have been a little bit late, but cut off by the third baseman. So Lawrence delivers with two RBIs here to give Hudson the 4-3 lead.
Oh, that hit was just what the doctor ordered right there. Scoring the two out there from second and third. Big hit, big play.
Yeah, absolutely.
Hudson goes up by one on that one. Oh, exciting inning here for Hudson as they're rallying with one out still. A man on first. Great. Great hit.
I think we're going to have a pitching RBIs. Change here too, Ken. So maybe cut to a commercial. We'll get
a dog or
the
two?
Number, and yeah, I'll go get you a hot dog, big boy. No. I'm out,
he says. And there he is getting hot dogs for us. That's Aaron Sundin over by the grill. Shake and bake. Get a good one for us up here in the booth. Nice camera work by Jeff, our ace cameraman. A great crowd up in the stands here, and as Jeff pans around, Carlson will be up to bat for Hudtown. One out, one on first. Big fourth inning here by the Hudtown crew. And Carlson up at the plate. First pitch is a strike. A little bit more heat from this pitcher. Carlson will watch that first one go past and set up for number two. Wow, striped right up the middle. Nice hit The runner advances over to third. Oh, fumbled out there in the center field area. They'll score another one, and here comes, wow, just an overthrow at third. Make it a infield home run as just a couple errors happen there. Hudson able to capitalize with two more. Woo, 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 woo! Come on, baby!
So I'm trying to get ketchup and mustard on your hot dog.
And they're doing this.
I heard a hit.
Carlson stripes one out to center field. They score the runner. Carlson runs to second. They overthrow. They go to third. Overthrow. He comes home.
So double? Is that what I hear? Where did the ball go? I'm just trying to score it.
Ball went up center field.
Over the center fielder's head?
Yep, and he kind of fumbled around with it.
Okay, so we're going to give him a double.
Yep, and then
RBI, obviously, but big hit. All of a sudden, my back's turned. I hear a hit, and I'm trying to hustle back up here, and gosh, he must have got around the bases quickly. So
he was cruising. Well, and they just kept missing on the throw, and he's like, oh, I'll get another base. And then they threw to third and blew it over third base, and then he came home.
It's perfect.
Boom, boom, boom.
Perfect.
Yep.
All right.
Thanks for the dog, partner. I appreciate that. You know, if this keeps up, maybe we send you for another dog and see what else happens.
Well, you know, I got to talking a little bit down there, too, so that was partially my fault. But I'm back. Landon Zulu, the batter. Happy to be back with a bigger lead, a couple more runs.
You'll be happy to know that Jeff found you on the camera down there, and we cut to you real quick.
Oh, really?
Did a little play-by-play on the buying of the dogs.
Did you?
Yep. I noticed Jeff panning around. I'm like, oh, cut in on this quick.
Look at that guy. He's just sweating like fat guy wanting a hot dog.
You look good. You look good.
3-1. Big swing that time. So, obviously, a lot of energy down there.
Mm-hmm.
I'm sure Jeff's picking up some of the enthusiasm from the Hudson faithful.
Yeah. Yep, he cut over to the crowd there in the bleachers right to the left of our box.
Lined out to center field. Center fielder a little deeper that time. Sets up, makes the catch for out number two.
Dose of them babies. The bus.
Hudson coming to life here at the plate. Again, bottom of the fourth. Hudson with six in this inning.
Man's a menace.
Ball one to Jake. Line drive out to left field.
Woo!
Turned on that baby quickly.
Takes that one for a ride.
Buzz
Hansen.
Dancing.
Bubba Booey, Bubba Booey.
Buzz Hansen started this inning off with a double, and he scored. First pitch to him in there for a strike. So kind of what the doctor ordered for Hudson, a leadoff double.
Mm-hmm.
We've talked about this before, how hitting can become contagious. Got that one on the corner.
Comes in bunches sometimes.
It can. 0-2. So how do you feel now looking at your hot dog all ready for you to eat? And it's just
very, very tasty. You did a great job with the mustard and ketchup.
I did it myself.
Wow.
But I was having a little trouble with the mustard, to be honest with you, Ken. That's what kind of delayed my return. That one's outside. 2-2.
Mustard was giving you a little problem.
Give me
there.
a little fit.
Well, looks professionally done.
Jake over at first base. Decent lead.
2-2.
That one's hit. High fly ball. Right fielder chases. over to make the catch. Boy, Bezanson gave that a ride. Jam job. Actually, it was probably about 10, 15 feet from going out of here.
Wow.
Foul territory, though. But for Hudson, six runs on, let's see, one, two, three, four hits. A big inning for them. They take the lead after four innings. It's Hudson 6, Eau Claire North 3.
All righty, back at it here at Raider Field. Getting a pitch count from the coaching crew. 88 is the call in the booth.
Hesselman, the batter, Logan Hesselman.
Seems like a good year to graduate from high school.
88, that's right.
Yeah.
Swing and a miss that time. 88 pitches officially now, 89 for Burkhoff. So probably the last inning we're going to see him. He's going to try to get a couple outs here. Ground ball up the middle. Zuli able to get the backhand on it, but not able to make the throw. Just took him a little bit too deep in the hole. Infield hit for Hesselman here to lead off the fifth inning. Brings up Brayton Thillman. Hudson again with a three-run lead after that big fourth inning. Don't see anybody warming up in the Hudson bullpen. That would lead me to believe it's probably somebody that's coming off the field here that's been playing already. Busson would be my best guess. Coach Blagan doesn't want to let this one get away, so he'll go to his number two, 1A we'll call it, pitcher.
And then that resets if you make it to that next.
To the sectional. Yep, it has to do with days off. And ground ball down to Rambo. He's going to tag the runner. Nice play by him knocking that down. Hard hit ball, able to get control of it. Come down the line, he would not have probably won the foot race to first. So tag play there. Out from Rambo one. For out number one.
I'll bring up Gorman for the North squad here.
Gorman. One of my favorite baseball players had the first name Gorman.
Really?
Storm and Gorman Thomas for the Milwaukee Brewers.
Storm
remember him?
Gorman, I do not.
Mm-hmm. Home run in here. He was your prototypical brewer back in those days. He had a great big mustache, kind of a little beer belly, because that's what Milwaukee's known for.
Yeah.
And he was the king at home runs and strikeouts. He'd either do one or the other. There wasn't much in between for him. So
that's great.
0-1. That one's inside. Gets away from Carlson. Runner will advance to third. So 1-1 here. Watch Gorman, the number four batter. A couple of strikeouts so far today. Eight on the ninth for Burkhoff. Just misses that time. 2-1. So as I mentioned, the winner of this game will take on the winner of Chippewa Falls and D.C. Everest. We saw D.C. Everest, of course, earlier in the year. They do have a very good pitcher. I'm thinking that's the young man we saw when they played here. Hudson was able to get that win 3-0. Chippewa, not necessarily deep in pitching, a very good hitting team. So Gorman draws the walk.
Which I guess that's an equation that can work, though, right?
Hey,
if you can keep up with the runs the other team's putting up on you.
Right. Yeah, you gotta have decent pitching, obviously. But man, if you can hitting can alleviate a lot of warts.
That's right. That's right.
Hunter Carlson making the call to the infield here, deciding what they're going to do if that runner does take off. One out. Keeping an eye on Coach Blagan there in the Raider dugout up against the fence. He knows the pitch count now is at 97 for Burkhoff. First pitch is outside. He will be able to see through this batter here.
Mm-hmm.
One and oh. That one's fall back.
1-1, one out here. A couple runners on the corners.
Chase Watkins is your batter. Watkins walked and scored back in the first and flew out to center field back in the fourth. Swing and a miss that time. Runner at first, not really giving an indication he's going to take off. Rambo holds the runner at first. Nice block that time by Carlson.
Ooh.
Excellent job. Moved laterally, knocked it down. Able to square off to that runner at first. Runner decided not to take off, so protected a base there for sure. 2-2. Got him. Ooh. Oh, boy. There you go.
Wow.
I wasn't sure what the call was there.
Yeah, right? I was thinking ball, but got him on the strike.
All right. Pitching change coming in.
That'll do it.
I think it's we're going to see Mr. Bussin.
Take a quick breather. Well, Bussin will come in to get us through, I think, by the end of this one.
Yep. In an infield switch, you got Landon Zuli going to shortstop.
Yep.
Jack Solheid comes in to replace Zuli at second.
All right.
Now batting throw player number 22, Trenton Palmer.
So, again, nothing will change in your batting lineup. Burkhoff was not batting, so Bezanson is the DH. So just a defensive switch for Hudson, bringing in Solheid. Two outs here. Trenton Palmer, the batter. Runners at the corners.
Palmer's been good at the plate tonight.
He's hit well. Yep. A couple hits for him. So he's going to see a lot of the same stuff he saw against Burkhoff just on the other side. Jake throws hard. Fastball, he'll mix it up with a little off-speed stuff. Inside that time, a couple tight ones. 2-0.
Got two outs, right?
Two outs.
Thank you.
2-0 pitch. That one's jammed and fouled. 2-1.
Well, Bus, he's got some heat too, huh?
He just gets up there and slings it, man.
Just bam.
He says, I know that I got a hose for an arm. I'm just going to throw hard. 2-1. That one's a greaser. Foul back. Nothing but fastballs so far for Jake.
Sweet heat. Speaking of sweet heat, you ever had that Asian zing sauce at B-dubs?
Yeah.
Kryptonite.
2-2. Oh, boy, just missed on that.
Yay.
Palmer wanted to go after
full
that
count.
One.
Full count. Yeah, that Asian zing, you can get at Sam's now.
Mm.
They pair it with another bottle of the garlic parmesan, which mm-hmm. I also like.
I've seen the runner's goal. Just misses that time.
Mm-hmm. So load him up.
Now batting
two down, though.
Number five, James Jarzynski.
All right. Jarzynski, the batter.
What's he done on the night?
He had a single and an RBI back in the first. Strike out his last at bat. So tying run at first. Go
good.
Ahead, run yep. at plate. First pitch in there for a strike. In there again, strike
good.
Two.
Boom, boom.
So far, I haven't seen Jake mix up speeds much, just kind of mixing up locations. See if he goes with something here to throw the runner on, the batter off. Curveball that time, good block by Carlson.
Mm-hmm.
1-2.
Yep, Carlson's doing a yeoman's job back there behind the,
very
the plate.
Job,
he's
yeah.
doing just great.
And he's got a great arm, too, so fun to watch him.
Mm-hmm.
Yep. 2-2. Good job knocking that one down as well. Jake trying to mix it up a little bit, locations and speed. See if he comes back to the gas here. 2-2. Curveball misses. Full count. Runners will be moving.
Give him something here, or you try to
you
hit
have
a corner?
To, otherwise you're going to walk in a run. So he's going to be coming at him. Ground ball, slow roller, got the force play. Third baseman sets up Abrahamson and throws. Nice stretch,
wow,
Abrahamson getting
gun.
There, charging. Rambo as well, good job on his end on the stretch. Hudson survives the threat. Four north, no runs, one hit, a couple walks, bases loaded, they get out of it. After four and a half, it's Hudson 6, North 3.
Welcome back to Raider Field. Ken Conan, Aaron Sundin, Jeff Tierstig out getting the sunburn today. That's you.
I need more aqua.
That's yours, yeah.
Okay,
that
thank
is
you.
Yours, my friend.
Thank you.
Yep, we got to keep the our main talent. We got to keep you hydrated, my
okay,
friend.
Okay, okay.
Yep.
Or I'll just
I'll start talking
just
like this.
Peel right over, yep.
Wyatt Gavin leading off for Hudson here, top of the fifth, leading 6-3. Bottom five, my bad. First pitch, ball high. Missed this last inning, but your pitching substitution for North is number 13, Elijah Rathke. 1-1, Gavin. Fouls that one off. Third baseman chasing.
Boy, they are hustling over there.
Yeah, a lot of green on that left side. That one gets out of play and drops in for a foul. One and one here on Gavin.
You're getting resupplied with some waters in here.
Oh, sweet.
All right, we got 1-1 here.
1-1.
Thank you, sir.
Eight hits for Hudson, four for North. Curveball that time in there. Woo! For a strike. You could see
wow,
the change of speed on that pitch.
That was a bender there.
One of the big stats, North, with two errors. That
thank
one
you, thank you, thank
is
you.
High.
Appreciate it. This is you.
2-2. Ooh, all right.
Yep, nice thank cold you. One. Yep, thank you.
Oh, thank you. 2-2 here.
Keeping us hydrated up in the booth here.
That one's low. Rathke thought he had a strike there, but definitely low. Brings the count full. Gavin, the leadoff batter here, bottom of five for Hudson, leading 6-3. That one's
outside.
Outside. Good hold on that one.
Walker, Texas Ranger.
Wyatt. So Hudson with the leadoff batter on again here.
Baseman number 19, Eli
Rambo, 2-for-2 on the night. Singleton scored back in that sixth run, fourth inning. Runner goes, Gavin down there.
Booyah! No problem.
Plenty of time, no doubter. He was in there.
Aggressive on the base running out here. I'm liking
Gavin's
it.
Gavin's got good speed, so yeah. I like to see that. See Coach Blagan getting that runner in scoring position here.
Get him for a strike on that one?
Yes.
Thank you.
Strike one. Yep.
0-1.
Squares to bunt. They're going to steal again. Ball drops out of the catcher's glove. So Gavin in there,
wow,
safe and sound, no throw.
Just hustling around the bases out there. Oh, Gavin makes his way over to third. 0-2 here for the Rambo.
That was a tough one to square up. That was a curveball. He'll be swinging away here on a good pitch. See if he can put it in play, and that one's high. Again, North with the infield in, trying to protect that runner at third.
Rambo with a little fluff on the chin there, I see.
I like a little that. Senior fluff?
Yeah, a little dirt on the chin.
High again.
2-2.
Were you, did you ever have the beard or goatee? You probably had a... You probably had a handlebar mustache back in the day, huh?
I couldn't grow hair on my face till I was 40. Oh, goodness. He tells him to hold tight.
Yeah,
I was a late bloomer on that facial hair. Yeah. And then when I could, I was just like, I'm growing a beard. I'm never getting rid of it.
Haven't shaved since I was 40.
That's right.
Full count. There you go.
It is.
Three for three for Mr. Rambo.
Rambo!
Gavin comes in. Rambo seeing the ball well tonight.
Yes, he is.
Another ribby for him.
Just takes it down that third base line. Great solid hit. Got behind in the count. Hung in there and pops one fair. Nice job. Another RBI for him, right? He's got a couple on
the night. Couple RBIs, yep. Well, we see another pitching change coming, Ken.
Really?
So that was a short hook.
It was a short-lived deal there.
Aiden Ecker, your new pitcher for North. You probably got time for a break if you want to.
You know, I was half thinking to run a water down to Jeff.
Oh, you do that. I'm
just
going to
mute.
We can.
You're live. You can mute. All right. If you want, whatever. I'm going to run him
extra water here for live.
Oh, you do. Perfect.
It is warm here now that the sun's come out. We were able to put a little shade in the booth here, but we're facing straight west, so no mercy from the sun.
Universal signal of we got water coming for you.
We got water.
He's like, I need sunblock is what I need.
gives us the nod.
Gave us the nod. We gave him the double thumbs
up. You and I, we think of ourselves first. We should be thinking of Jeff first, right?
We do. We're so selfish.
In fact, I could have bought him a hot dog. I didn't even think about that.
You didn't buy him a dog?
I didn't even think of it.
Bro! Well...
I owe him.
You do.
We'll go to Jonesy's or something.
I was going to say, we're going to do it end of the year. Maybe we'll get three of us out for a little Jonesy's postseason recap is what we like to call that when the wives ask.
Jeez. That's okay.
Typical entertainer.
Typical talk guy.
Can't
just
remember.
Just cares about himself.
Don't bother with the production crew. All right, 7-3, Hudson. Bottom of five. Got Rantham up to bat. Yes, Eli.
Rantham up to bat. A couple of Eli's in a row here.
Mm-hmm. Got Rambo out at first.
Rambo at one. He's getting a pretty good lead over there.
He's ready to go.
Scores the bunt. Oh,
hey, Rantham! Oh, my goodness!
Oh, they pulled up. That was a smart play. That looked like it might stay fair. It was a beauty of a bunt.
Yeah, it really was.
At the end, rolled foul. I was wondering why Rambo was so far off the base there. It's like, all right, well.
Ready to rock. Going to my first Twins game in a couple years next week.
Cool.
Yeah.
Those are fun.
Yeah.
I was looking squares again. That one's low. I'll get to a Twins game or two this year. I want to get down to Milwaukee again. I haven't been down there for probably 4 or 5 years to a Brewers game. Have you ever been down there?
I've never been, and it is on my wife and I's kind of to-do list for this summer.
Yeah, it's offers that time. Throw down to one. Rambo's back. I like the old County Stadium, even though it was time to move on because it was getting to be pretty ratty. And, but those were that parking lot where you would go and tailgate and stuff. That, I mean, you come down the highway on that, and it's just a plume of barbecue,
really
charcoal smoke.
Loving it.
But the new stadium, it's pretty darn cool.
I've heard it's pretty sweet.
I'll always call it Miller Park. I think it's American Family Field now. Line drive out to right field. That's going to drop in there for a base hit.
Rambo. Come on, moving Rambo around out there.
Rambo.
Let's go, boys. R squared out there on the bases.
Sam Abrahamson,
let's go. Hot Watson getting the bats a going these last couple innings.
All right, well, let's see what Coach Blagan has in mind here with
thanks for dropping
Abrahamson. Walked his last at bat. I would not be surprised to see another bunt. Just keep an eye on. Well, again, you got nobody out. You got third base trying to cover the base back here. If he can lay down a nice bunt on the third base line, those runners are going to move, and he might score. There it is, Ken.
Ooh, almost got away from him. Ball.
It's an interesting situation to put the defense in because now all of a sudden your pitcher's got to become aggressive attacking that bunt, as does the catcher.
Sure.
Fouls that one up. Oh. Oof. Mm. That's tough. Those are hope for the best to get that one laid down, but that one's popped up. Out number one.
Keep a couple runners out there.
Peyton Lawrence, your batter, back in the fourth, had singled, scored, and a couple RBIs for him. So see if he can keep things going here. The
goodness.
The Eli Squared crew on the base pass for the Raiders. Hudson up to 10 hits now. Of course, 7 runs. We are still bottom of 5. Looked like a good pitch that time. 1-1. Again, winner moves on to Marshfield for sectional quarterfinal against the winner of D.C. Everest and Chippewa Falls. Lawrence fouls that one back. Been trying to kind of keep an eye and see if I could find some scores.
Yeah,
I'll do it again maybe between innings.
Yeah, baseball just isn't quite as tight as football.
You know, the places that report, they all have to report their scores to the WIAA after the game.
Sure.
But it's ground ball, that's going to be to the shortstop. He boots it.
Oh, goodness.
Not going to be able to make that throw.
Goodness.
I think he was trying to, he saw the runner coming from second base, knew he had a force play there, but couldn't get a handle on it. So we're going to score that one in error, but the runners move up. So Hunter, the big inside the park home run guy.
Ooh, he has got some dirty pants out there.
Yeah. Getting back to those scores, it all has to do with fans. So, or who's at the game reporting
sure,
it.
Sure, sure.
And so I think that's probably why you get more readily scores from other sports, just because people are watching the game and might not report it as it goes along.
Just one out still. Base is loaded. Carlson, our catcher, up at the plate.
Ooh. Ground ball. That's going to score a run, though. Takes the force play at one to get Carlson, but Rambo comes in. That's about the contact we talk about, Ken. Getting it in play, getting that run in.
Yep. We'll take that.
Number 7, Landon Zuli.
Zuli.
Hudson now with runners at second and third. Two outs, two runs in. Landon Zuli, your batter, playing shortstop now after the bussing pitching switch. Curveball that time. That's going to drop in over second base.
Get down.
Right
there
field.
We go.
Lawrence
score
is going to come in and score. Two more runs.
Boom, boom.
Two more runs on that single from Mr. Zuli.
I had a feeling, and I didn't say anything, but I just had a feeling he was going to drop
feeling.
One in out there.
For the Raiders, pitcher number 3, Jake Bussing.
The Bus.
Bussing singled his last at bat. That one's inside. Another good run, or another good inning for Hudson with 4 runs in here. Zuli, the runner at first. 1-0 on Jake. That one's in there for a strike. 1-1. Throw over to first. Zuli's back.
Yeah,
Old Glory in my way here a little bit again. That one's fouled off right side. 1-2.
Still just one out.
Two outs.
Excuse me, two outs. Thank you, thank you.
Fielder's choice that
thank you.
Last at bat for Carlson. So.
Thank you. Trying to keep the scoreboard right here. Appreciate that.
1-2. Jam job. That's popped up. Called for by the first baseman. He parks underneath it, makes the catch to retire the side, but Hudson gets four on a couple of hits. They leave one. Your score after five innings, it is Hudson 10, Eau Claire North 3.
Welcome back. Let's see where we're at here. So weather's up the DH for North here.
Knox Weathers. Uh-oh.
What happened?
Hang on, Ken. Drop my shades. I'll be right back.
Oh, boy. Man down. Man down. A strike on that first one. Foul ball.
You know, my future's so bright, I got to wear shades.
You do. You wear them all the time. You wear your, what's that old song? Wearing your sunglasses at night?
I wear my sunglasses at night. 0-2. Ooh, high on that one. I have no score so far in the River Falls Lincoln game, so we'll check around again. I'll check and see. Maybe Chippewa's got a score. DC Eversus. That's the game that really impacts this one. 2-2. Knox Weathers the batter. Bussin delivers. That one's fouled off, out of play, down to the hollow.
Home run hollow. Thought I was going to miss that place more than I did this year.
I like the turf.
Yep. And once we got the internet dialed up at the turf, it was all good.
I like it.
Yeah. It's fun. We had a good little setup there.
2-2. That one's in the dirt. All right, so I got Chi High Baseball Twitter.
Four count.
Swing and a miss.
K-time.
Bussin with his first strikeout. Actually, I think that's his second. I don't have exactly when. I think that's number two for Jake.
Dose of them babies.
I had 9 strikeouts for Burkhoff before he hit the pitch count. Brings up Ryan Hull.
That's awesome.
Jake Heater. Steve Wright.
I like the umpires, like, kind of slow six-shooter out the side.
Yeah. Kapow. Curveball. Dandy. Did not offer.
Didn't take it.
Looked like a pretty good pitch, but... One and one. Pass ball in there for a strike. Yep. Could hear him that time.
Caught that corner.
No luck so far on scores. We'll try to check it again. That one's low. 2-2.
Somebody could probably make some money if they could figure out how to get all the scores aggregated somewhere.
Not
just baseball, like everything. Like, here's where you go.
Well, and again, I bring this up. It's a weird thing to score because I think I mentioned before the game changer and experience with that in the past. And if you don't know what you're doing, it's not accurate. And I mean, I've had times before where I haven't been in a game and I've asked my kids, how'd you guys lost? No, we didn't. We won, 10-2.
Gosh,
well, had the other
really?
Team winning 10-2.
Really?
So I think football's a little different. I mean, they're scoring, obviously, mm-hmm. but it's touchdowns. It's not... I don't know how to explain it. It's more intricate. Hit by pitch that time for Mr. Hull. The scoring is a little bit more intricate, and how baseball gets scored. That's why they do pitch counts. That's why they do, count errors, hits, runs, ball strikes, outs, all that stuff.
Right, right.
Or football's points.
Right, right. Just cut and dry. Boom, boom. Yep.
Now, obviously, they take other stats for football, too, I realize, rushing yards, passing yards, but I don't know. Ken, I'm just rambling. I'm getting dehydrated. Thanks for getting me under water. I appreciate it.
We got a cold one waiting for you right here. Thank you. I mean, we are ready to hydrate you.
Quit talking.
Ball one. Yeah, you imagine being a player out there wearing one of these black or dark blue jerseys?
Huh. Yeah.
Carlson. Boy,
two balls there. Boy, that one last pitch looked pretty good. Carlson throws her down to first. Runner back.
Two balls. One out.
Didn't miss by much. 3-0.
Yeah, the sun really came out. We had storms threatening, and there's a strike. Threatening early, and then straight sunshine.
Yep, we're back to the sun.
Back at it.
Gertz, the leadoff batter, is your batter. Struck out twice. 0 for 3 on the day so far. That one's tight. Gertz draws the walk. Hole moves down to second.
Well, this weekend just looks like a steamer, too, doesn't it?
I know. Yeah, we're kind of getting July weather in early June.
Straight into it, yeah.
Logan Hessem in the batter. That one's in there for a strike.
There you go. Boom. Six shooter out the left side. I will say the breeze coming up the stairs is helpful.
Yeah. 0-1 pitch. Get some swinging on that one. 0-2.
There we go.
Jake up to 33 pitches here unofficially. Looks at that runner at second, comes to the plate. Grounded out over to second base. Solheid makes the play. For out number two, runners advance to second and third. Brings up the left fielder, Brayton Thillman. Two outs.
Couple runners out at second and third.
That one's in there for a strike. Bussin pitching out of the stretch here. Doesn't give much of a look to those runners. He's just going to attack the batter here.
Mm-hmm.
Gives third base a look, but he's coming to the plate. Another fastball strike. Quickly, 0-2.
90-ish. Got a little zip on that rip.
I'd be surprised if we don't see another fastball. This one might not be greased across the plate, but... maybe a little high, get him to swing. Curveball, fouls that one off. That was nasty.
Woo!
Still 0-2.
Yep, heading the count big time here. Two outs.
Line drive out to center field. Lawrence gets good jump, parks underneath it for out number three. For Eau Claire North, no runs, no hits. Two left. After five and a half, it is Hudson 10, Eau Claire North 3.
Welcome back to Raider Field. I'll tell you what, our friend Jonesy sends us a text.
Ah, I think we've got the game.
I think we've got your dogs beat. I mean, look at these guys.
Show off.
They're whipping up
You're a show off, Jonesy.
Plates of just goodness. Oh, my goodness.
All right, Mr. Bazanson.
Thanks for sharing, Jonesy.
Up to the plate for the Raiders. Having a great night at the plate. Of course, we talked about his leadoff double back in that big fourth inning for the Raiders. Follows that one back. 1-1. I didn't even think of this before. You know, we were talking about... Bees dancing to remember Bazanson, sure, yep. But Bazinga.
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 Bazinga from the Big Bang. theory.
Bazinga Bazanson up to the plate. 1-1. That one's in there for a strike. 1-2. Boy, the right fielder is playing very shallow.
Let's see.
To see if Mr. Bazanson can get a hold of one here. That one's inside. He greased one pretty good his last at bat. It was foul, but it did not miss the fence by much.
That pitcher from Jonesy reminds me of your, who is it? Oh, goodness.
Curveball high.
Who's he hanging out with?
Ybarra?
Ybarra, yes. Yeah. Those guys, and we're whipping up that food during football season. We got to figure out a way to get over there.
We do.
Like pregame. We should run a pregame from the
Jonesy, will you cater us in the booth?
I was gonna say, let's get go over to your bars with Jonesy. They're all hanging over there, and do a pregame. I don't know if they're there that early, but think about it, guys. We're throwing a shot, throwing a lifeline over.
We'll
to
come
you.
Eat your food we'll for nothing.
Hey, we'll
make sure it's cooked to our liking.
We'll promo anything you want.
Wyatt Gavin up. Bazinga Bazanson on base.
Bazinga Bazanson.
Curveball outside.
I like that. Hey, you got to throw the line out. You never know. They did invite us for a grill
they
out
did.
One time. Or more than one time. Those guys are awesome.
Bazanson looking like he's going to steal here. No. Ground ball down the third base line. They're going to go to two, get the force there. Over to first in time for Gavin. Good hustle. We saw him leg out a single earlier. So the fielder's choice there. Bazanson out at second. Brings up Eli Rambo. 3-for-3. Couple of RBIs.
He's having a heck
scored
of a
twice.
Game.
He's having a great game.
Heck of a game. Call him the big rig out here. That one's in the dirt, though. Advanced the runner, I think.
Yeah.
Yep, there
He's
we go.
He's going to round it. Catcher just getting to it over by the north dugout.
Pitcher had to tell him, oh, it's over your right shoulder.
Yeah, it's hard sometimes for those guys with the mask on. You see him shed it quick, but if they didn't see where it bounced off or it went, sometimes you can get a couple bases on those.
Sure.
So Gavin in scoring position here. See if Mr. Rambo can deliver again. 1-0 pitch. That one's in there for a strike.
Pretty good.
One and one here. Gavin getting a good secondary lead there.
That one misses. Tried to frame it up. Not going to do it.
Yeah, Eli was he 0 for 2 and fought that back. Couple foul balls, got full count. Oh, off the
ball's
glove.
Ball's loose.
That was a pretty decent pick play. Would have been close, but I think Gavin would have got back in there. I like that he's aggressive on the base paths.
Getting that
head
jersey
games.
All dirty.
Playing head games with the pitcher.
Head games.
Who's saying that?
I don't know.
Come on, bro.
Like that one. Come on.
Why am I schooling you all the time in classic rock?
Yeah, my mind is not built like that. I'm not good with the facts.
Foreigner.
I loved it back in the 80s, though. So.
Oh, yeah. It's some great tunes. 2-2. Gavin going. Fouled off. Got a good jump there, too. Little hit and run by Coach Blagan.
We'll keep the 2-2 count. One out. Dugout very chirpy over to our left.
You know, it's too bad. That hillside's pretty cool back there. Where all these fans are.
Yeah.
To play again. Gavin back. I think he might have caught that one in the knee. I think Coach Blagan, I'm going to have to tell him, get some bleachers. Get the fans a little closer to the action.
Right? Yeah.
So, because we can't hear any of those people up by the trees.
It would be fun to have some bleachers running down that.
There are quite a few people right behind the backstop here, which is nice. And, of course, there's some bleachers there. But still 2-2. Gavin aggressive out there. Ooh, just a little low.
Hey.
Rambo knows the strike zone today, though. We'll trust him. Full count. Fouls that one back.
He's battling. He's battling. Rambo a senior as well, right?
Yep. Yep. We're going to talk about the seniors here. Maybe before we get into the...
both Rambos.
Both Rambos.
Dose right. of those Rambos. I forgot about that.
Speaking of Rambo, curveball outside. Another good at that by Eli. What's your favorite Rambo movie?
Probably the original.
I really Me like too, the original. First Blood.
Yeah, you can't good. Beat that. I don't know if you're watching Tulsa King on if you
That's
get that
a
Paramount.
Good show, too.
Yeah, I like that Tulsa King.
All right, Bennett Brathel up to the plate. Hitting for Eli Ramthan. Brathel, a sophomore. First pitch is in there for a strike. Yeah, that's a good show. Oh, anything Stallone. I mean, come on. Expendables, those are all good. Of course, Rocky.
Yep. My gal's not a big fan of, well, I don't think she's ever been a fan of Sly. But I like him. That Tulsa King's a fun
runner
one.
Runner goes. Throw down to third.
Wow, what
Gets
wheels.
Underneath it.
Come on now.
That's why they want him on base. He's got some speed.
Sheesh.
Aggressive base runner.
Giddy up. Got hot mics over here, people. Keep it real.
That's his dad back there.
Guy's chirping in. Oh, even dads, though. You got to keep it real. Grandma and Grandpa get on our case over here.
1-1.
Thank you. 1-1. That's his dad. I like that. All right. I guess you can chirp if you're related.
Infield in again.
Mm-hmm.
If I'm north, I'm thinking we just want to get an out here.
Yeah.
Okay, good pitch, but that's outside. 2-1.
Yeah, that looked like earlier that would have been called a strike.
See if Brathall can put one in play here, get that runner home. Gavin.
Low.
That one's low. Yeah, it does seem a little tightened up, but we can't see in front of the plate, so we're just kind of basing it off of location behind the catcher and umpire.
That's right.
Foul back. Full count. Full count on Brathel. See if Bennett can...
Dugout's really getting her going.
Get some action here. Ooh, got him. Mm. Fastball that time.
K-time.
Gavin's doing a good job of kind of getting in the head of that pitcher a little bit. If you watch him down the line, he's making sure he's making eye contact.
Oh, really?
Trying to ensure the pitcher's at least giving him a look every time. Two outs here brings up Sam Abrahamson. Down the line. Curveball outside.
Woo. Catcher doing a good job sliding over to grab that one.
One and oh. Runners. Doing the
you see Rambo little, out there?
Little head shake out
the
there.
The head shimmy. Oh, yeah, Rambo with a little look off, a little head shimmy, a little shake and bake.
He's playing with house money with nobody protecting the base there, so
nobody's
you can do what you want.
Yeah, you can do a little dance.
Get a good secondary lead, a little moonwalk back to the base. That one's in there for a strike.
Moonwalk.
Hard to do in cleats, though. Kind of you're moving slow.
There's a team that I saw, and I don't know the name of them, but my wife's got us on the list.
Oh, yeah. It's that Bananas team.
Gosh, really funny.
They are hilarious.
Absolutely funny.
Ooh, got him right in the back.
I'll wear that one. That'll be a walk.
Base is loaded. Back to the top of the order here. Peyton Lawrence, your batter.
Yeah, what are they called? But is it the Bananas? Is that
they're
the name
something
of the team?
Bananas?
They are okay.
And they do all kinds of stuff. I saw there's one guy that literally his strike zone is maybe 2 inches. He's short to begin with, but he gets himself so low in his crouch that there's no way you're gonna throw him a strike, right? He looks like he literally looks like a 4 year old.
Right.
So he's crouching how low tiger. He gets. And in fact, I think he's doing the splits.
So nice.
They're the Bananas, but I gotta think of that name. Is it the Banana Splits? No, just maybe the Bananas, but
yeah, we're on the list, though. We're on the list. Wherever they're playing, when we get it, boom, we're going.
You're
going
to go?
Yeah. Yep. Yeah. Well, it's looking pretty fun.
Mm-hmm.
All right.
I'll tell you a quick story here in a second.
Who's up here? Is this Berkoff?
Nope, we're back to the top of the order. Peyton Lawrence.
Lawrence. Got it.
Base is loaded here. That one's in there for a strike. So I had a family reunion this weekend. I ran across one of my uncles who played City League baseball till he was mid-60s.
Okay.
And then he moved to Florida full-time after he retired, and he kept playing. He switched to slow-pitch softball. Curveball in there for a strike.
Yep.
And I asked him, I said, are you still playing? And he goes, I hung it up this winter, 82 years old.
Hung it up at 82.
And he was and he was an outfielder.
Yeah.
And he said, I'm playing with these other guys that are over 60. You know, they're like, so runner goes. Gavin coming in here. He's going to score. Runners move up. Another run for Hudson. Anyway, he's one of those guys, too, that's pretty fearless.
Yeah.
So I know darn well he's giving up his body and all this kind of stuff. And I'm like, Uncle Don, you're going to break your neck or something. But that's pretty impressive. Somebody that's played ball probably since he was 10.
Oh, that's super cool.
70-some years. Line drive.
Ooh, turned on
down
that
the third base line. That's going to score a couple more.
Wow. Hudson, let's go.
That's your run rule, Ken. That's your walk-off. Two runs in. Makes the score 13-3, and that's your ball game.
That's it?
That's it. Lawrence delivers.
Cash and checks, homie. Let's go.
The regional championship there.
That was a blast from Hudson.
There it is. Hard line drive. Smoked down that third base line. And that's your ball game. Hudson wins 13-3. In that bottom of the sixth, they pick up three runs on a couple hits, some aggressive base running, and on to sectionals, on to Marshfield.
What's next? Marshfield, Wisconsin.
Marshfield. And so, as we said, it's a quad, so how it works is there's a game at 10 o'clock, so in the other part of the bracket, that team, whoever comes in, now that's based on seeding, so I'm not sure if Spash loses, if Hudson then gets the first game. Regardless, kind of what talking to Aaron, Coach Moen, A.D. Moen, I know him as coach.
Yeah.
He thought they'd play at noon, so that's your kicker, is that back-to-back game. But, you know, what we saw tonight was some resiliency from Hudson. They're down 3-0. They've got their ace on the mound, struggled a little bit, but again, kind of a typical Berkoff, nine strikeouts. But he walked a few people. It's nice to have that luxury, being able to go back to Jake Bussin.
Yep.
But now you're talking about a day where, let's say that one of those two get banged around a little bit, it's going to stretch this pitching staff.
Sure.
And so I think
keep
that in mind. Again, I would guess that you're going to see Berkoff pitch game one. And then from there, you know, it's going to be Jake, and then down the line, we've had some other guys that we've seen this year. Nick Hirsch pitched the other day. Aaron Schweckler did a nice job. Jack Jensen. So that depth is going to be crucial.
Yeah, big deal, yeah. Especially
on
the
that day
here.
For sure.
Yep.
And then, again, the bats. If you can get the bats going. So Hudson this year, if it is Chippewa Falls, they meet in the sectional. They split with them. First game, they 10-run them. I think it was 11-1. Next game was 4-3. We saw DC Everest here. That was the game Schweckler pitched. They won 3-0.